The offset function probably isn't one you'll use every day, but we'll show you how it works and one example of how it can be useful. That way you can think of other ways that it might come in handy for you. Offset uses a point of reference to return a reference to another cell or a range of cells. It can have up to 5 arguments, but the last 2 are optional. We'll start by showing you how it works, so I'm just going to type offset here. And we start with the reference. In this example, we have a spreadsheet that has monthly sales. Let's say we want to return the last 3 months worth of sales, and we're just going to test it out to the side here and then show you a use case of how it can be applied. So let's say we want to start with using the first cell, that's A1, as our point of reference. I'm going to type A1 here as my reference, and that's the starting point from which we want to base the offset. And the next argument is rows. Rows is the number of rows to move away from the starting point, whether up or down. So because I want to report these 3 rows here, the number of rows is, in this case, going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 rows down. The third argument is columns, and that's the number of columns away from the reference point that I want to move. In this case, I don't want to move away from the reference point. It must be in the same column, so I'll type a 0 here. And the last 2 arguments, the optional ones, this one tells us how many rows the result should contain, and that's the height. If we don't enter an argument for the height, then the height of the reference is used. In which case we only have 1, so it would just be the 1 row. So here I want it to be 3 rows. I'm going to type 3. And how wide do I want the return values to be? I want it to be 2 columns wide because I want to return both the month and the sales. So I'll type the number 2. Close parentheses. And here's what happens. We do get the names of the 3 months and the value of sales for those 3. And of course, because we're in the dynamic array environment, we get a spilled result. If you're not using dynamic arrays, then you'd simply enter the formula as a CSE formula, meaning that you'd hit Control-Shift-Enter instead of just Enter. So let's get rid of the formula. We're going to simulate a non-dynamic array environment, which means we need to highlight the output area, type the formula, and use Control, Shift, and Enter. And we get the same result, but the difference here is that we see these curly brackets inserted by Excel to show us that this was entered as a CSE formula. So this is how the offset function works. This looks great, but in this case, it won't do exactly what we want, because if we add another month here, then we're stuck with April, May, and June, because we hard-coded the number 4 in here. So how do we make this dynamic so that if we add extra rows, it'll always return just the last 3? All right, it means that we need to do a calculation. So let's get rid of this formula. And what we need to do now is to think about how to make this formula dynamic. So of course, we'll start with offset again. We keep our reference as A1. And how will we determine the number of rows to move away from A1? We'll basically have to count the number of non-empty cells that are in this column. And for that, we can use the count A function. So we're doing count A, the number of non-empty cells in column A, but we have to account for this row and this row, all right? Because as of now, we have 8 rows of data, but we're really only concerned with these 6. So we need to get rid of the 2 that have nothing to do with the data that we want returned. So we're telling Excel that we're only concerned with these 6 rows of data by removing the 2 that don't contain the data that we need. And how many columns away from the source do we want to move? Well, it's 0, because we do still want to return the items that are in column A. What's the height of the data? All right, so now Excel has moved down And it's taken us here because it's moving 6 rows down from row 1. So we're here. And what's the height going to be? Well, we know it'll be 3 because we want the last 3. But because we want to return 3 rows backwards, starting at A7, then we type minus 3. And finally, the width should be 2. Close parentheses and enter. And that's what we need. We have the last 3 rows of sales data. So that looks great. Of course, if you're not using dynamic arrays, you'd enter this as a CSE formula. But now, what if we want to just return a single figure here? Then we can nest the offset function with the average function, and it works great. So here's the formula for the offset that we have here. If we entered the average function here and changed what we have so that it no longer takes into account the first column. So instead of telling Excel that we don't want to move away from column A, we want to move one column to the right. So now we're over here. And we will only want one column of data. We need a second close parenthesis for the average function. And that's the average. How do we know if this is right? We can just highlight here and check it on the Excel status bar. This looks great. Let's copy our formula right here. And so now if I insert another row here and say July sales were $2,789, this is accurate. We've updated and it works beautifully. And that's how we use the offset function. I hope this helps, and let us know if you have any other use cases for the offset function.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.